Right, so welcome to this new series of videos that I've been wanting to do for quite a while. And yeah, it is a series of playthrough videos of the career mode of Kerbal Space Program. So let's start the new game and start a new save, which would be career mode, that is right. And we name it Program, yep, and change the flag to the retro one, and of course take a look at the difficulty settings. And as you can see, I have installed quite a lot of mods, and yeah, we will slowly take a look at what I have installed here. And we will allow other launch sites, because with only the Kerbal Space Center active, it won't really be fun to build some things like large space stations and some like cooperation missions. So advanced. Let's make it a bit more difficult. That one, dang it, it's a nice mod which will introduce some part failures and some wear and tear damage. Let's just activate failures on all parts and manual failures just for the fun of it. And now I'm looking on how I can reduce the rate at which the failures occur. Never mind, we can change that one later. Kerbal Constructs. Show hidden bases. Ah, if they are hidden, we will keep them hidden. Maybe we will find one or two of them. Crash the simulator. Research bodies. Yeah, I better not touch this, because I experienced that if you mess with the research body settings, you will have a level 3 research and development facility at the very beginning of the game. So, snacks. Yeah, I like that one. CP. Let's see if Tarsia Space Technologies is working. So anyway, let's accept everything. We have set up our flag, we have chosen a name, and I think we can start. Yeah, I've got it. I might have played Kerbal Space Program for quite a while. So here, this is the Kerbal Construction Time mod, which basically like reduces the frequency at which you can launch, because every vessel that you design has to be built first in the VAB or the SPH. And so like it cannot just toss out one rocket after another. And let's see. Oh dear. That's it. Spend upgrades. So what we can do now is we have 16 points. that we can spend into upgrading the VAB, the SPH, and the research and development department. And yeah, at the beginning of the game or through the entire game, I prefer to build vertical lift off rockets, so better spend most of my points on upgrading the VAB to make the VAB build my rockets at a faster rate. So let's spend 7 of 16 points at the VAB. And I don't even know what spending points on the research and development department will do, because I did not play too much with the Kerbal Construction Time mod yet. But I think it's, yeah, let's make it like this. And 3 points to the SPH, so I don't know what the advantage of the research and development department will be, but I think that it, yeah, it is going to be important. So talking of the research and development department, we can take a look there, because I have the community tech tree mod installed and recently made 1 or 2 changes to the tech tree and moved stuff around, and I don't know yet if that did work. Well, it did work for the ejection cover, but yeah, it seems to have worked quite well on most of the stuff here. But I think that will do for now, because for the first things that we will fly, we won't really need, oh jeez, that ambient sound is loud, we won't really need this later parts that I have changed. And basically I have moved a few parts around, because at the beginning of the game I prefer to build some satellites and probes and send them to the moon or to Minmus, instead of just building one Mark 1 command pod after another, which has a shitload of experiments strapped to its side to just somehow grind all the science points that you need in the beginning of the game. Later, getting science points will be easy. They will just come in and I don't even know where to spend them, but at the beginning of the game this grinding process is quite slow and painful indeed. So one more thing is set up the EVA suits as I always had them, with the pilot in red and white, the engineer in yellow and white, scientist in blue and white, and tourist, if we ever have any tourists, in green and white. But now at the beginning of the game with only the Mark 1 pod and later with the Mark 2 pod, I always prefer with this this low tech level command modules. I prefer to give the Kerbals this vintage spacesuit from the Making History expansion pack. So let's just give them all this this vintage spacesuit, and later when we get to the more advanced kinds of spacecraft, we can change to the actual normal EVA suit. And of course we will have to disable the real-time visor reflections, because there is some texture problem, and but we have to hide the parachute backpack, because the normal EVA suit backpack, in my opinion, is such a nice model and texture that it is a real pity to hide it under this quite ugly parachute backpack. And What is the point of wearing a parachute when doing an orbital EVA? So yeah, let's hide it. And I think what I did not even mention yet is that this is on KSP 1.8.1, because since 1.9 was released, there is a couple of mods that are quite important to me, like Scatterer or Copernicus haven't been updated yet. And I, like I say, I wanted to do this kind of video since quite a while, and I was always waiting for like to get my installation going. And literally on the day that I got my 1.8.1 installation going, 1.9 was released, and then I was waiting. And I recently have a little bit wrecked my 1.9.1 installation, so now I just reverted to 1.8.1 and got it going more or less, and yeah, I thought I can just start to make this video. So let's go into the VAB. And of course we know what the VAB does. And yeah, let's not take this Mark 1 command pod, but instead filter by manufacturer, and I think it was at the yep, there it is. Because for this real, literally botched together rockets that you have to build, because you don't have any other chance at the very beginning of the game, I actually prefer this this old model of the Mark 1 pod and of the solid rocket boosters. And then later, when the things get a little bit more sophisticated and a little bit more advanced, we can change to the normal Mark 1 pod. Let's put it there for comparison. So let's search for the yep, there it is, for the SRB, and put we actually have quite a lot of parts, which of course most of them come from mods. So let's set up my staging and add some science parts. They don't do anything, but we can put two experiments that we already have on the sides. So crew is Jebediah Kerman, and yeah, I think we are ready to go. Of course, when your spacecraft is named Untitled Spacecraft, is never a good sign. So yeah, yeah, I wanted to press the launch button, but completely forgot about the Kerbal Construction Time mod, and like I say, I have installed it not so long ago. So here's my build list, and it will take 15 days to build it, but actually it's not bad. Yeah, I don't know if it kept recording during the load screen, so let's just start over again. I think it's not bad that it takes 15 days, because I almost forgot something seems to be a little bit wrong here, but I think it is still functioning. So anyway, we can take up to 2 contracts. We have 5 available, and out of this 5, of course, we can launch our first vessel, and we can gather scientific data from Kerbin. So we have taken our 2 contracts to actually gain some funds from what we are going to do. And here the Kerbal alarm clock mod already shows us this, that it will take 15 days for our very simple rocket to be complete. Let's just remove that alarm, and here it is. EAB and warp to complete. And there it is. And yeah, basically this Kerbal construction time mod. The construction time is depending on the part count of your vessel, and once it is completed, like now, you can roll it out, which will take 14 minutes. It will be quite fast because this little thing that we have built literally weighs nothing, and the rollout time is depending upon the weight of your vessel. So let's just again warp to complete and press the launch button. We have Jebediah Kerman inside. Everything is ready. Let's go. And this reminds me of the... I think we will keep it that way. There was this stupid slack contact again of my DVD drive. I hope it did not interrupt too much. So anyway, we have... I was taking a look at Scatterer. And let's double check our staging and the parachute. Everything looks fine. So let's activate SAS. And let's go for our first launch. I think you cannot hear me right now over this quite loud little solid rocket motor. And here we are, we can start to collect science with this cardboard box from the how was it called? I think it was from the Kraken science mod. So let's collect that one. Take a look at the good old mystery goo. The goo jiggles and wobbles as the craft flies. And once we hit the upwards is the highest point of our flight, which is now, as told me by Kerbal Engineer. If we activate the parachute, let's time warp down a little bit from around 5.5 kilometers of altitude. And I almost forgot the crew report. To get as much science as possible. Let's time warp a little. We have landed, sort of landed a bit hard right next to the launch pad, so we can take our second set of science experiments. And yeah, basically, yeah, the goo accumulates near the water facing side of the container, so which I guess at the shores would be the downside. It's very surprising. And observe the cardboard box, it's just cardboard. And set Jebediah Kerman on EVA to collect an EVA report. And recovered. Recovered to VAB because that would speed up. So here we are recovering to the VAB, speeds up the building process of the next vessel. So we have collected almost 25 points of science, and it takes us 5 minutes to recover this what remained of our rocket. And I think, yeah, I guess that the closer you recover to the KSC, the quicker the recovery will be. I don't know, we will see. So we have altogether 39 science points. and 112,000 funds. So, and here from the Final Frontier mod, Jebediah Kerman has earned this. I'm too lazy to talk it through. So anyway, let's go into the research and development department and take a look on what we can do with the science points that we have earned. And yeah, of course, with 40 science points we can take both, but yeah, anyway, this one has the advantage of giving us the hammer, the larger solid rocket motor, so we can fly higher. And with this one we gain, we get more experiments, so we can do more science, and we also get this decoupler, which will come in very handy in 2 minutes. And with our remaining 30 science points, we can take only one of the three nodes. So I'd kind of like to know why we would get two Sampas, but we won't need them now. With this one, we won't need either. But this one here, the survivability, comes in handy with all these new experiments. So we can collect more science. So let's remove that alarm and time warp a little bit ahead. And we can actually take a look I think we can do this contract. We won't escape the atmosphere yet, that's for sure. And actually, I wanted to put the hammer, the large solid rocket motor, at the first stage, and this one we can do. So let's test the TD12 decoupler. And let's see what. Ah, now I can see it will take 9 days to research the basic rocketry node. So this is what the. What spending points onto the research and development department will do. So let's remove that alarm again and just press here warp to complete. And now we can edit the untitled spacecraft that we have recovered. So we can take this TD12 decoupler to just only recover the command pod on the parachute. Then place the flea under it again, put in another decoupler, put in the hammer, and in order to test it on the launch pad, put in yet another decoupler. So this should do. We can keep these two experiments because I'm quite confident that this rocket now would hit the upper atmosphere with a new situation. So we can do these experiments in another situation where we will actually get more science points. And also we will land most likely in the water, we will splash down, so this gives yet another situation. So we will need 2 mystery goo pods and 2 cardboard boxes again. But anyway, we would need two pieces to just keep the rocket balanced. So let's do all the staging. Now we can set up the parachute to partially deploy at 75% atmospheric pressure. So it will be stay partially deployed for a much shorter period of time. And with the first rocket, if we did it that way, it would just become too fast until it reaches this 1500 roundabout meters of altitude where the parachute would partially deploy. Because of the additional weight of the empty motor, it would just be too fast and cannot deploy the parachute. And so let's see. Hold on, there's one more one more node in the tech tree yet unresearched. It explains why we don't have so much so much experiments available yet. So let's save the edits and leave the VAB. Yeah, it still takes 2 days until we. No, it takes 2 days until the. Two days until my spacecraft is finished, but 29 days, oh shit, to research this tech tree node. So let's remove this alarm. And warp to complete. So here we are. Let's go back to the VAB. Complete this very botchy, very botched. Fuck it. So I think if we put this experiments around there, because of course we do not want to obstruct the entry hatch. This is the exact reason why I did this changes to the tech tree, because I do not like to having to build stuff like this for ages until you somehow can research far enough into the tech tree to actually put something into orbit. So I rearranged it a little bit that it becomes much easier to build a little unmanned satellite. So we can save the edits and have 11 days to wait. Warp again to complete without Kerbal Alarm Clock, because Kerbal Alarm Clock would slow down the time warp when it gets closer and closer to the completion. So let's roll out, again remove, and warp to complete. So let's launch it. True is, but we will now put Valentina Kerman as pilot instead. So let's launch. And the chatterer has changed to a female voice. So let's take a look at our two contracts here. And again, activate SAS. Staging looks good. And one more thing. No, it's not here. Because I think I do not have Force Science installed, but if I had, I would have deactivated it now. So SAS is active, staging looks good. And let's go. The first contract is completed. It's quite bad that persistent rotation covers up the... oh dear, it becomes unstable. I think we are not going to land in the ocean. We are not going to splash down. And we aren't even going to reach the desired altitude in the upper atmosphere. So anyway, we can do this two experiments. No, we cannot do that one again. But we can do this. No, this. The temperature scan. The gas analyzer, whatever it is. The microwave oven, which is something that I really like from the... we are going to splash down in the water. Which I really like about this Kraken Science mod, that it keeps this... this Kerbal style of experiments, like not doing something real and something serious and scientific, but just let's shoot a microwave oven into space and see what it does. And the sample box, whatever it is, probably the only male sample I collected. The barometer. And the photometer. Parachute. Let's time warp ahead. Flashdown. It's a good thing that we put two of these cardboard boxes, because one of them was destroyed. So let's observe the other mystery goo. What does it say? It wobbles around, no wonder. And it's shaking in the sea scale. So... is it... crew report. Let's take a crew report and an EVA report, which is going to tell, I already know it, that the spacesuit was not necessary to get there. So let's go inside again. And oh, we didn't even complete this parachute contract. So let's recover. recover to the VAB again. But we earn 48, fine. So next one. And we move that one. And let's take a look on what we can do. Won't need that one. But 67, 45 plus 18. Ah, we would need 68 science points to research into aviation, because if we researched into aviation, we could build a plane that, yeah, comes in handy to yeah, to research various biomes on Kerbin and eases or really helps to gain science points in the beginning of the game. So I think we can end this episode at this point, because I have seen that it is already way over half an hour long, and yeah, let's do this, reaching the upper atmosphere and then building the plane will be something nice for the next episode. So yeah, if you have liked it, but actually I do not expect that very much people are going to view this. So if you have liked it, you can feel free to leave a like and a subscription both to this channel and my main channel. And I hope to see you again in the next episode with the plane.